the middle of the frame, horizontal frame, and do 3 inches from that to the next line. 3 inches should be 3 inches. So the next one should be 3 inches. And you wanna do, you can do three inches. In this case, they decided to do an additional 3 inch line or row. So it ends on 9. And then, 5 inches to the next one. 5 inches to the next one. 5 inches and so on. Okay. The leaf is designed, it has two sides. One has a valley, and the other one has a groove. And we just slide it right in.
Bucket, slide up close to this side or something, or whatever.
Yeah, well, that one probably will work good. Slide a little bit and that's it. That will work. Okay. We need to make sure that our track ends on that corner right there, and we have this 5 inch leftover of the thatch. So as you can see, our rows go where the marks are there. Okay. Okay. I do this one here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's better. So there. Marker. Marker. There. So here we have the opposite corner. So we have leftover. So I'm gonna cut following the middle of the structure. Precise cut. Make sure you don't cut the structure metal or the finish. Oh, I'm out of order. Okay, now we go where our mark is. And we cut the leftover, but make sure that you are covering this section again, just like on the opposite side. Okay? 6, 7. 2, 4, 6, 7. And this one has 3 pins. The middle of the leaf. This way, turn it over, middle of the leaf here. And then we flatten the cup. There's your corner here. That goes here.
Placing of the ridge cap, and it completes the whole process and installing the thatch on this tiki. That's the final step, and it has to be centered and properly placed with several screws, much like the rest of the thatching. Pretty much this concludes.